Henry Brown and Silas Green were friends. Ooh-ah. But for a woman, even friendship ends. Ooh-ah. They fought it through one early morning, and without a word of warning, neither ever lived to win her hand.
They talk about the duel, they talk about it yet. A bitter duel fought to the end. They counted off the pace, then whirled face to face, because of Nellie Baker. Friend killed a friend.
Just outside of town.
Ooh-ah.
The sun came up, they shot each other down.
Ooh-ah.
For the love of Nellie Baker, Hank and Silas met their maker, never knowing it was all in vain.
They talked about the duel, they talked about it yet. A bitter duel fought to the end. They counted off the pace, then whirled face to face. Never to shine anymore. The lover she had was good and true, but she left him far behind. When she came to the West, as so many do, her fame and her fortune to find. Her fame she found on the dance hall floor, where her beauty would turn your head. For she was the queen of all the West. Now the beautiful star is dead. One night, it was the lover she jilted so long ago, and there he shot her down. Not many an eye with tears is wet, and many a laugh is still. For the beautiful star of Texas lies in a grave on a lonely hill. Henry Green.
This is the true story of how young Henry Green murdered his wealthy wife. Come listen to a tragedy, you people young and old. I'll tell you of a story, will make your blood run cold. About a dear old lady, Miss Wyatt was her name. She was poisoned by her husband, and they hung him for the same. This lady was so very rich and of a high degree, while Henry Green was very young, as you could plainly see. Said, my dearest Mary, if you would be my wife, I will always love you dearly and guard you with my life. When Mary's brother heard the news, he rushed right to her side, saying, sister dear, you died, but doctor told me so. There's something I must tell you. I swear by heaven above that you have just been poisoned by the husband that you love. Now Henry was arrested and soon returned to jail. He had to wait his trial, cause the court would not take bail. His greed for money led him to the murder of his wife. And on the cruel gallows, they took young Henry's life. Here's a very sad story of poor Naomi Wise, who fell for the sweetness of George Luther's lies. For she met him as she promised, and they went for a ride. And then that villain choked her, and poor Naomi died. When they found her poor body below the old mill dam, they all blamed George Luther, who claimed he was an innocent man. Then they took him and they tried him. In court, no one could say that he killed poor Naomi on that sad and fateful day. But they say on his deathbed, as everyone surmised, George Luther claimed he killed her, killed poor Naomi Wise. It's been told that her spirit around the place still flies to warn the sweet young ladies from all men.
Jesse James was a man who was known throughout the land. For Jesse, he was bold and bad and brave. But the dirty little coward who murdered Mr. Howard went and laid poor old Jesse in his grave. It was on a Wednesday night when the moon was shining bright. Two gunmen went and robbed the Glendale train. And the people laid it safe a many miles away. 'Twas the fearless outlaws Frank and Jesse James. Along came Robert Ford, that sneaking little coward, a man like Jesse many times had fed. Now he ate up Jesse's bread, and he slept in Jesse's bed. Then he laid poor old Jesse in his grave. Yes, it was on a Saturday night when Jesse was at home, just talking to his family brave, when that sneaking Robert Ford shot Jesse in the back and laid Jesse James in his grave. How the people held their breath when they heard of Jesse's death, and wondered how he ever came to die. But it was that dirty coward, that sneaking Robert Ford, that shot poor old Jesse on the sly. Now Jesse went to rest, his head upon his breast. His family, they were brave. 'Twas the little coward who murdered Mr. Howard, went and laid poor old Jesse in his grave. Went and laid poor old Jesse. Asked him to come in. She told him that she loved him, and she asked him where he'd been. But loving Henry couldn't stay and be with her alone, for the girl he left on the Arkansas line thinks he's a long time coming home, a long time coming home. They stood in the garden just talking soft and sweet. But that girl had a dagger, and she stabbed him oh so deep. Yes, you forgot a woman's scorn can strike a mortal blow. Now your heart's blood comes dribbling down, and now your breath is growing slow. Your breath is growing slow.
And so, loving Henry, you'll make love nevermore. You'll love a man, you'll leave him.
Now you know the score. Some took him by his lily white hands, some took him by his feet, and they carried him down to the water's edge. And then they plunged him into the deep, plunged him into the deep. So lie there, loving Henry, just be there all alone. And the girl you left on the Arkansas line thinks you're a long time coming home. A long time coming home, a long time coming home.
Oh, Bernie Benson, he was sure the marriage kind.
The marriage kind.
Oh, Bernie Benson, he was sure the marriage kind. Any maiden, girl, or widow he could find.
And he could find.
She was sure to leave his single days behind.
Marriage kind, marriage kind.
Bernie Benson, he was sure the marriage kind. There was once a pretty girl he met in town.
He met in town.
Oh, there was once a pretty girl he met in town. So his wife, he simply had to let her down.
Let her down
right in the sea until his wife, she came to drown.
Marriage kind, marriage kind.
Bernie Benson, he was sure the marriage kind. Now a wealthy widow, she then came on by.
She came on by.
Now a wealthy widow, she then came on by.
Came on by.
Bernie told her single and polite,
he never lied.
So he just had to take his wife and make her die.
Marriage kind, marriage kind.
Bernie Benson, he was sure the marriage kind. Fifty gravestones on the meadow you will find.
You will find.
Fifty gravestones on the meadow you will find.
You will find.
Mrs. Bernie Benson, they have all been signed.
They've all been signed.
But Bernie Benson, he is still the marriage kind. Marriage kind.
Marriage kind.
Marriage kind.
Marriage kind.
Bernie Benson, he is still the marriage kind.
I came to town from Louisville just hoping I would find the lovely girl from Michigan so pleasing to my mind. Her rosy cheeks and rolling figure was the best. They called her Lovely Mary, the Lily of the West. I courted her for many days, her love I tried to gain. But all too soon she slighted me, which caused me grief and pain. She robbed me of my liberty, deprived me of my rest. They called her Lovely Mary, the Lily of the West. One evening as I rambled down a lonely shaded grove, I saw a stranger in the arms of my one and only love. I rushed up to my rival, put a dagger through his breast. I was betrayed by Mary, the Lily of the West. Now my trial has come up, sentenced I will be. They brought me to the courtroom, there convicted me. But she deceived the jury, so simply did she dress. She far outshone bright Venus, my Lily of the West. Since then I've gained my liberty, I've served my sentence through. I've traveled near and traveled far, find my loved one true. Although she stole my liberty, deprived me of my rest, I'll always love my Mary, the Lily of the West. I'll always love my Mary, the Lily of the
cowboy, all wrapped in white linen, wrapped up in white linen, as cold as the clay. I see by your outfit that you are a cowboy. These words he did say as I boldly stepped by. Come sit down beside me and hear my sad story. I'm shot in the chest and I know I must die. It was once in my saddle I used to go dashing. Was once in my saddle I used to be gay. But too much hard playing and too much hard drinking, I know I've done wrong and I'm dying today. Oh, we beat the drums slowly and play five lowly, and bitterly wept as we bore him along. For we all loved our comrade, so brave, young, and handsome. We all loved this cowboy, although he'd done wrong. Let me tell you of a story of a good man who went bad. He had walked the straight and narrow till a wicked woman drove him mad. He was settled down and married and his wife was meek and mild. But he killed his wife for freedom, for a wicked woman drove him wild. When he rushed to tell that woman of the thing he'd done for her, her reply then drove him crazy, for she said, "I do not love you, sir." Then she laughed at him and told him that she had no heart to . So he killed that wicked woman, for her kind does not deserve to live. Just before he pulled the trigger of the gun against his head, never love a wicked woman was the last thing that he ever said.
Hangman, don't you tie that knot. Another neck I haven't got. Hangman, loosen up that knot. I'm much too young to die. I'm gonna get bail, get out of jail, my freedom I will buy. A hangman's knot is not my lot, I'm much too young to die. Yes, there's my father on the way, my bond to pay without delay. Father, father, bail me out. You won't, you came to see them hang me to the tallest tree.
A hangman's knot is not his lot, he's much too young to die.
Yes, there's my brother on the way, my bond to pay without delay. Brother, brother, bail me out. You won't, you came to see them hang me to the tallest tree.
Oh, hangman, don't you tie your knot, another neck I haven't got. Hangman, loosen up your knot, I'm much too young to die.
I see my sweetheart on the way, my bond to pay without delay. Sweetheart, sweetheart, bail me out. You will, you wouldn't see them hang me to the tallest tree. Oh, hangman, please take off that knot. Here's one neck you haven't got. Hangman, loosen up that knot. This time I don't die. But I got my bail, I'm out of jail. To you I say goodbye. A hangman's knot is not my lot. It's nice to say goodbye. It's nice to say goodbye. It's nice to say goodbye.
Some say just